Good morning. My name is Dan Watson. I'm the Deputy Director for the King County Housing Authority. I'd like to welcome you all to Patrick Place, to supportive housing, 68 units for formerly homeless men and women. We're here to acknowledge and to celebrate the passage within the Omnibus Appropriations Bill, some key legislative provisions that have expanded the 9% low-income housing tax credit for the first time in 10 years. This legislation was spearheaded by our own U.S. Senator Maria Cantwell. And I'm here because my executive director, Stephen Norman, is out on the East Coast. He was working in Washington last week on a number of policy and legislative issues. He would like to send his regrets as well as thank the senator for her outstanding efforts to get this legislation through the Congress. The 12.5% expansion is expected to add about 29,000 additional affordable units nationally. And those of us that are in the business understand the critical nature of these tax credits in sort of creating the investments that's necessary to do low-income housing. It's far and away the biggest source of investment in low-income housing. And though affordable housing is known by the community, it's an important priority for many, many communities in this region, the role of the tax credit is fairly obscure and not well known. And because it is not well known, I think it makes it even more impressive what Senator Cantwell has accomplished. She has been an absolute champion on this issue for many, many years, and finally in 2018, her persistence has paid off. And the timing actually couldn't be better in many, many respects. First of all, we're witnessing, I think, record-breaking increases in rents and home prices. We have unprecedented levels of homelessness here in King County, and over 100,000 households are now severely cost-burdened, paying over 50% of their income either towards rent or mortgage payments. 70,000 of those are renters. And perhaps what is not understood is the Tax Cut Act that was passed in December of last year reduced the many incentives to invest in affordable housing. It's estimated by some that we've lost about 200,000 units nationally over the next 10 years just because of the tax cut alone. So this is a small down payment on an important issue. It's a step in the right direction, but by no means is it the complete solution. At this point, I'd like to introduce Mayor Jenny Durkan. In the short time that she's been in office, she's made affordable housing a key priority of her administration. She's identified over $100 million in low-income and affordable housing investments, and she sees as a progressive vision for Seattle affordable housing being a key component of a vibrant and diverse community. Mayor Durkan.
Thanks, Dan.
Thank you.
Thank you, Dan, for that, and thank you, Senator, for having us here. This is really an important day for the city of Seattle, and I can't thank Senator Cantwell enough for her leadership on this. You know, affordability and the housing crisis and its related problem of people experiencing homelessness is the moral challenge for Seattle right now. And we are working as hard as we can to get solutions to this. I just want to say at the outset, you know, I had the good fortune to go back to Washington, D.C. with the U.S. Conference of Mayors. And while there, I met with a range of people on Capitol Hill, telling them that what we needed in Seattle was certain things, help on affordability and homelessness, help on our opiate crisis. And everyone had great ideas, but when I sat down with Senator Cantwell, she said, here's what we're gonna get done. And today, we're actually seeing that she got it done. And it's gonna make a huge difference. Her leadership on this will make a difference in Seattle. We know we have to do more. We know that there is not a one-size-fits-all solution, but I can tell you just in the short time I've been here today talking to some of the residents who live here, knowing what a life-changing thing it is to know they have a place to call home.
Yeah.
That's what we want. This is about the people. It's not about abstracts. It's not about financing. And Senator Cantwell, being the person she is who can dig into the budgets and know what the intricacies are, knew how to help people and how to do it on a scale that will make a huge difference in the city of Seattle. So Senator, I want to thank you so much for that. We know that in the last 5 years, the low-income housing tax credit has provided over $181 million in affordable housing in Seattle. and it's helped us produce over 1,000 homes. Those numbers are astonishing. I was able to announce last year at the end of the year $100 million that we will spend on affordable housing. Because we can leverage that amount, it will equal $260 million around that amount in affordable housing. So these tools are allowing us to take the funding that Seattle taxpayers gave us and make it even bigger to help more people. Because that's what this is all about. This is about helping the people who can't make ends meet, who've been displaced, who are experiencing the real friction of growth in Seattle. And I've had time to talk to Senator Cantwell on this. She understands the human dynamic. She wants to help the people, but she's not doing it on a small scale. She decides to go in on a larger scale to give us this tool that can grow what we need in the city of Seattle to make a real difference in people's lives. We will move to a more equitable and affordable Seattle. This is going to be a tremendous tool for us to continue to leverage, and it's going to last into the years in Seattle. So again, I want to thank the Senator, and now I'd like to introduce Chris Herman, who is the Executive Director of Washington State Housing Finance Commission, who will tell you some more about this. Thank you very much.
All right. I'm Jim Herman. I'm the Executive Director of the Washington State Housing Finance Commission. Almost exactly 2 years ago, we were in this very same place with Senator Cantwell at an event when she announced that she had introduced legislation to increase the low-income housing tax credit program by 50%. And today, she has returned with the first major step forward, having a 12.5% increase in housing credits for each year for the next 4 years, and also creating an opportunity in the legislation to serve additional low-income households in the high-cost areas through income averaging. This is the first significant increase in housing credit in 10 years, as Dan said, and it could not come at a more critical time, not only for Seattle, but for Washington State. As you all know, we're in a very deep crisis of housing affordability and homelessness that is affecting communities of all sizes in Washington. Because of our good economy, between 2016 and 2017, we added 126,000 people to our population. But unfortunately, we're short about 118,000 homes for all those new residents. Rents are rising faster here than anywhere else in the country. The average rent in Seattle is now $1,842 a month. And there are 16% fewer rental homes available than what we really need statewide. We know that over 400,000 Washingtonians are paying half or more of their income monthly towards their housing. And in 2017, vacancy rates reached historic lows across the state. In Ellensburg and Walla Walla last year, they were less than 1% vacancy, while statewide we had a 3.2% vacancy rate when 5 to 7% is considered normal. Here in Seattle, I just saw a chart in Governing Magazine showing that our cost of living is higher now than Chicago, Boston, and Denver, just to name a few of the larger cities. So given these realities, it is no surprise that we have an affordable housing and homeless crisis that, until now, has gone unrecognized at the national level. Fortunately, in Washington State, we have a community of smart, dedicated, affordable housing providers who have risen to meet this challenge with all of the tools they have available, including the housing credit. But every year, many more projects apply for the credit than we can finance with the amount we get. In January, we received 35 applications for the 2018 round of the credit, projects all over the state serving communities of every size and people of every kind in need of affordable housing. Unfortunately, we could only finance 15 of those projects. But today, thanks to the increase Senator Cantwell won in the other Washington, I'm very happy to say we will immediately be able to add 3 more projects to that list. One is a stone's throw away in Redmond, where our friends at Imagine Housing are adding affordable housing to the big Astera Park mixed-use development next to Microsoft's campus. About 50 individuals and families will live there in the heart of opportunity, and 24 of whom will be formerly homeless people. On the other end of the spectrum, in a project that will build 50 new affordable apartments for working families, many of them agricultural workers in Royal City, east of the Cascades in Grant County. And finally, west of Spokane, this increase will build new apartments in Airway Heights, including three-bedroom units for large families. This project will help alleviate the displacement of families from closed mobile home parks in that area. And of course, we know that these 150 or so units are not the end of our state's affordable housing crisis. But for those families who will live in these three very different communities, they are a lifeline. It is for this reason that I owe a great debt of gratitude to Senator Maria Cantwell for her incredible persistence and single-mindedness that brought us to this day. Everyone in Washington needs to know that for the past 2 years, Senator Cantwell has worked 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, traveling across Washington and other states, both educating and encouraging other senators to join the fight to make this increase in resources happen. Senator, speaking for everyone that will find a new home in the three additional projects we will find this year, and the additional projects we will fund in each of the next 3 years, I hope you know how deeply you are appreciated, not just here in this room or in the state, but across the country. Ladies and gentlemen, our champion, Senator Maria Cantwell.
So we're here today to celebrate the fact that that campaign has been answered with the first investment in 10 years in affordable housing, so that for us in Puget Sound, at least 3 to 4 more Patrick Places will be built each of the next 4 years.
Right.
We're so happy because we know here at Patrick Place, we see the change that it has given individuals in their lives. We celebrate the fact that these solutions put people on the right path to having economic opportunity here in Puget Sound. We know that this crisis affects so many people, returning veterans, retiring baby boomers, people in need of workforce housing, and that, as has already been said, too many people are paying more than 50% of their income for housing. So, we in Puget Sound know that we are at the most expensive part of this crisis in the United States. That as the 2007 housing crisis impacted the entire country, we saw 7 million Americans lose their home, and we saw after the return of our economy here in Puget Sound, thousands of people moving here in seeking of new economic opportunity. So we know all too well, because we travel the entire United States communicating this story, that somehow the demand had increased, but supply had actually decreased. Affordable housing had been taken out of the market, both in projects that went to market-based rates and the decline of housing writ large. And what also happened was that the homelessness in this country increased. Seattle has the third largest homeless population in the country with over 11,000 people without a permanent home.
I think that's unacceptable. The mayor thinks that's unacceptable. And today, we are redoubling our efforts to try to address this problem. But we're here today to celebrate that after 2 years of hard work going across our state and across the country, we were able to find a solution. Working with Senator Hatch from Utah, who as a state certainly believes in a housing first model. They took care of their veteran population without asking a question. They just said, let's put a roof over everyone's head and then we can go from there. So securing his support, we introduced legislation, as Kim said, that asked for a 50% increase in the low-income housing tax credit, the source of credit that funds 90% of the affordable housing units that are built in the United States. That, we felt, was our challenge, communicating to people who wanted to do something about the crisis, that if they really did, they had to increase the credit. And that challenge came at the very time people were doing tax reform and putting resources into other things that we thought, basically, were not as important as making this investment in affordable housing. So we were so happy when we were successful in getting the first bump in 10 years, $2.8 billion, that, as I said, will help us build 3 to 4 more Patrick Places a year in our state,
right,
and many more projects like this across the United States because of this new policy in the affordable tax credit. We also changed and put into the law for the first time a new provision giving an additional income diversity for moderate incomes so that they could be mixed with extremely low incomes and help create an incentive for more projects in areas that are particularly hard to serve. Now, if I could just put a little plug in, since we're here at Patrick Place and I heard the announcements, I'm standing next to the mayor, I hope that we'll see some future projects right here in Seattle as well. One of the things...
We're all for that.
2019.
One of the things that the mayor... No pressure, Kim. One of the things that the mayor and I both want to work on is workforce housing here in Seattle. We have a great restaurant industry. We also want restaurant workers to be able to live here and not have to commute 3 counties away just to their jobs. So we're so excited that the Seattle Housing Finance Commission has announced new projects today and that there will be new projects announced in the future. This means more for families, more for veterans, more for seniors, more for students, just more affordable housing across our state and across our nation when this issue is a crisis. It doesn't mean that this is the finish line. It just means we're going to have some ready information and results for our colleagues to show the economic impact these projects have had in our region and our state and why they have made the difference in moving our population forward. Some of our colleagues in the House of Representatives still don't get it. They didn't want to see this level of boost. They literally were worried that we would end up making it permanent. Well, I got news for them. We're not standing still. And you can invite us back in March of 2020. And we will be here to celebrate more victories. Because this is the right investment for our city, for our state, and for our nation. It is cost effective in giving people a place to live. It's cost effective in producing construction jobs and economic value, and it's cost effective in dealing with the affordability crisis that I guarantee you is not going away anytime soon. So I just again thank the people here from Patrick Place for allowing us to be here for the kickoff of this campaign 2 years ago and to be here today to celebrate with your residents. These are the people who literally inspired me to work so hard.
All right.
Dennis was here, and I'm sure you will be as eloquent as you were 2 years ago. But I want to thank Claudia for being here as well, and Claudia is a tenant at Alex Jackson, and if you would would like to share a few words and then introduce Dennis. Thank you so much. So they asked me to come today because I've been greatly benefited by a program that was funded by the Low Income Housing Tax Credit. I'm a 72-year-old widow, and I worked for 50 years, but I did not save $1.2 million, which is apparently what I need to live comfortably till the age of 84. My age group is the oldest of the baby boomers, and what I'm going to tell you today is a story, brief, that you're going to hear from hundreds and thousands of those people when they come out of the workforce. I thought that I wouldn't be involved in any kind of a program like this. I wasn't going to be homeless, but I had to get into a position where I could cover my monthly expenses with my Social Security check to try to keep my savings, as make them last as long as they could. But as you've heard here, and you all knew already, you can't live on your Social Security check in Seattle. So I was in a big dilemma, as many of us are going to be, and then one day I read that as part of the development of the expansion of the Pike Place Market, they were going to build, with funding from the Low Income Housing Tax Credit, 40 units of affordable senior housing. And it was like a miracle, and I just so thought that was the way I was going to be able to get through. So I went in early, and I was very diligent in all the paperwork, and I certainly qualified economically. And so a year ago, they told me that I was going to be one of the people who got to live in those 40 units. And really, it was a miracle for me and my family. And I can only say that there's going to be more and more people like me, a different sort of group than maybe where attention has been focused. And we're going to need programs so that we can live in the city, and so that the city isn't just rich people. It can be all levels of people. People like me that were middle class, maybe now lower middle class, and that we can still be there and be part of the vitality and be part of the diversity of the city.
Right.
So yep. I am so impressed by what these people have done. I want to personally thank them with all my heart and just encourage you. Still, she persisted. He seems to be a swell fellow.
Community leaders and fellow advocates. My name is Dennis. I'm a resident here at Patrick Place Apartments, and it's an honor to have you all once again here at Patrick's Place. It was 2 years ago that you, Senator Cantwell, launched your campaign against the nation, across the nation, to address our homelessness emergency by increasing the low-income housing tax credit. Thank you for continuing to lead the charge for affordable housing and championing the fight against human suffering. 5 years ago, I was released from prison for the fifth time onto a street corner in Camp Washington. Being abandoned at the age of five, abused in every possible way in the homes of the state foster care system, a lifetime on the streets, my wife overdosing and dying next to me in bed at night, and my 21-year-old daughter dying from life on the streets. There I was, 59 years old, homeless, addicted to drugs, and standing back on that corner in Kent again. I was tired, alone, and pretty much beat down. I turned away from the only life I knew and entered the Catholic Community Services shelter in Kent. After a year in the shelter, Patrick Place Apartments opened up, and I was one of the lucky ones to move in. I moved in with all of my mental issues, social issues, and fully addicted to drugs and alcohol to cover the pain of a lifetime of one trauma after another. With a safe and stable place for me to live and the amazing support team of case managers and counselors in the building, I have made giant steps towards rebuilding my life. I now have 1 year and 8 months clean and sober, and I also quit smoking cigarettes 13 months ago. I advocate for Catholic Community Services. offices and speak on social justice issues whenever I get the opportunity. I'm on the board of the Fremont Neighborhood Council. I organize community events. I'm a member of the St. Ignatius Spiritual Retreat Team that works with people in homelessness and recovering addicts like myself. I'm here every week with the HEM program at the Solanas Casey Center. None of this would have been possible without Patrick Place Apartments and its wraparound services and the kind and compassionate people that work here. This building was funded in part from the Housing Trust Fund and the Low Income Housing Tax Credit Program. Without the tax credits, Patrick Place would not have been built. I began my journey as a guest at a CCS shelter, Catholic Community Services shelter, 5 years ago. I have come full circle. I now work for Catholic Community Services at the University Friends Shelter that shelters 50 men each night, 365 nights a year. And I'm in training to work with families in homelessness at the Sacred Heart Shelter in Seattle. I am just one of the many success stories here at Patrick Place Apartments. We are so grateful for all the hard work you do, Senator. Without your selfless dedication and hard work, we would not have the chance to rebuild our lives, some of us reuniting with our families, living our dreams, and now being able to give back to the community. We thank you from the bottom of our hearts. God blesses those who are kind and compassionate and do good work like you do, Senator. And that is why I'm also sure God blesses the Catholics. Thank you.